In graphing linear equation using the slope-intercept form, we need to transform the equation from general or standard form into y equals mx plus b, in which the slope is just the coefficient of x and the y-intercept is the constant. What if we will reverse the process? We will find the equation given the slope and the y-intercept. Just stick around and I will teach you how to find the equation of the line given the slope and the y-intercept in an easy way. If you are new to this channel, kindly hit the subscribe button and the notification bell for you to be updated every time I will upload new math videos made easy for you. Let us recall our lesson about the slope-intercept form of the equation of the line. That is, y is equal to mx plus b, in which the slope is just the coefficient of x and the constant is the y-intercept. Let us review how are we going to find the slope and the y-intercept of the equation of the line given in standard form. So what we are going to do, we are going to rewrite the equation into y form. So this would be negative 2y by addition property of equality, 3x be transposed to the other side, so that will become negative 3x. Then we just copy positive 12. So whatever the coefficient of y, that would be the exact constant that we are going to divide both sides of the equation. So we're gonna divide negative 2 both sides. So negative 2y divided by negative 2, so that would be y. Negative 3 divided by negative 2, so that would be positive 3 over 2x. Then positive 12 divided by negative 2 is negative 6. So since the equation is already in slope-intercept form, so the slope is the coefficient, so that is 3 over 2, and the y-intercept is negative 6. Now, what if we will reverse the process? We have the slope, and we have the y-intercept, and we will try to find what is the equation of the line. How are we going to rewrite the linear equation given the slope and the y-intercept? In doing this, we're going to substitute the given slope and the y-intercept to the formula y equals mx plus b. Then after which, we're going to rewrite the equation into standard form or general form. How do we know an equation is in standard form? So it is written in the form of ax plus by equals c. That would mean the constant will be put at the right side of the equation. So it is general form if the right side of the equation will be 0. So let's have example number 1. What is the equation of the line whose slope is negative 5 and the y-intercept is 3? So the given, the slope is negative 5, the y-intercept is positive 3. Substitute it to the formula y equals mx plus b. So y, copy, our slope is negative 5, so just copy x. Our y-intercept, so just substitute 3. Rewrite this equation into standard form. By addition property of equality, transpose negative 5x to the left side, so that would become positive 5x. Just copy positive y, just copy positive 3. And notice, this equation is already written in the standard form. If we may rewrite this one into general form, just transpose the constant to the left. So that would be 5x plus y minus 3 equals 0. Now let's have example number 2. Write the equation of the line whose slope is negative 3 halves and the y-intercept is negative 1. So similarly, the given slope is negative 3 halves and the y-intercept is negative 1. Substitute to the formula y equals mx plus b. So the equation would be y equals a slope negative 3 over 2x plus our y is negative 1. Put that in the quantity. Now simplify, so y equals negative 3 over 2x, we just copy, then positive times negative, so that would be negative 1. So notice in this equation, we are dealing with fractional equation or the rational equation. So we have to get rid of the denominator. By doing that, we're going to multiply the whole equation by the LCD, and the LCD is 2. So multiply 2 to each term of the given equation, so 2 times y is equal to, so this term times 2, so 2 times negative 3 over 2x, then minus 2 times 1. So further simplification, So 2 times y is 2y. The numerator and the denominator have common factors, so we can strike this out. So multiply what is left. So 2 times y is 2y. Then this is 1. So negative 1 times negative 3x is just negative 3x. Then 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. So rewrite this. So by addition property, transpose negative 3x to the left side. So that will be positive 3x. Just copy positive 2y and just copy negative 2. So this is the standard form. If we may rewrite this one to general form, transform this constant to the left. So that would be 3x plus 2y plus 2. That would be equal to 0. Example number 3. What is the standard equation of the line whose slope is 1/2 and the y-intercept is 4 over 5? So the given, so the slope is 1/2. The y-intercept is 4 over 5. Substitute to the formula. So y equals the slope 1/2 x plus the y-intercept 4 over 5. So since again, this is a rational equation, we have to get rid of the denominator. We will multiply the whole equation by the LCD. And the LCD of 2 and 5 is 10. So multiply 10 to each term. So 10 times y is equal to this term times 10. So 10 times 1/2 x, then plus 10 times 4 over 5. Cancel the common factors. 10 and 2 have common factor, which is 2. So 10 divided by 2, so that would be 5. And 10 and 5 also have common factor, which is 5. So 10 divided by 5 is 2. So multiply. So 10 times y is 10y. Then 5 times 1 x is 5x. Then 2 times 4 is 8. Rewrite this into standard form. So negative 5x plus 10y equals 8. So in the standard form, the first term must be positive. So since this is negative, so we will multiply the whole equation by negative 1 so that we can change the sign of each term. And this is now the standard form of this equation with the slope 1/2 and y-intercept 4 over 5. What is the general equation of the line whose slope is negative 7 over 2 and the y-intercept is 3/2? Substitute the given formula, slope-intercept form. So this would be our equation. So we have to get rid of the denominator, multiply the whole equation by the LCD, and that is 2. So 2 times y, then 2 times negative 7 over 2x plus 2 times 3 over 2. Cancel the common factors. Their quotient is also 1. So what is left is 2 times y is 2y. 1 times negative 7x is negative 7x. Then 1 times 3 is positive 3. Rewrite it. So 7x plus 2y minus 3 is equal to 0. So we equate this one to 0 because this is general form. Example number 5. So what is the standard equation of the line whose slope is negative 4 over 3 and y-intercept of 0.2? So the given slope, now our y-intercept is in decimal, which is 0.2. So we read this fraction as 2/10, so therefore we can convert this one into 2 over 10. So reduce this one to the lowest term, so our y-intercept in fraction form is 1 over 5. Substitute it to the formula, so y is equal to negative 4 over 3, which is our slope, times x, plus the y-intercept 1 over 5. Get rid of the denominator, multiply the whole equation by the LCD, which is 15, the product of 3 times 5. So multiply each term by 15. So 15 times y is equal to this term times 15, then plus 15 times 1 over 5. Cancel the common factor. So the common factor of 15 and 3 is 3. So 15 divided by 3 is 5. Then common factor of 15 and 5 is 5. So that would be 3. So multiply, so 15 times y is 15y, then negative 20x, then plus 3 times 1 is 3. Rewrite this one into standard form. So transpose negative 20x to the other side, so that would be positive 20x plus 15y equals 3. So this is now the standard equation of the line with the slope negative 4, 3 and the y-intercept is 0.2. If you learned something new today, and if you like this video, please do me a favor, kindly hit the like button, and in the comment section, kindly send me your thought about this video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel so that I'll be able to help you learn math lesson in an easy way. See you in my next video. Thank you for watching.